And the Virginia gubernatorial race is sure to have a significant impact on upcoming midterm elections across the country. McAuliffe has campaigned with influential figures from the Democratic Party, while Youngkin has flown solo to keep the focus on state rather than national issues. News Nation correspondent Michael Shore joining us now live with the potential implications of Tuesday's election. And Michael, good to see you. Some of the people watching across the country might be wondering what all the fuss is about, but this race is a really important one to watch because it's considered the bellwether for the 2022 midterms.
Right, and it's something that political analysts say all the time. This is a bellwether, this is a bellwether. It's not as if in 2022 people are going to go to the polls, Rutabaga, and say, hey, you know what happened in Virginia in last year in November? That's going to dictate how I vote. But what it does do is it dictates how candidates will run next year. They will take lessons from how the candidates do this year in Virginia, whether it be a Republican distancing himself, as you said, from the former president, but still succeeding, or a Democrat running on the Biden administration's agenda in a state that the Biden campaign carried in 2020. So that's the kind of tactical bellwether that it is. It's not necessarily going to dictate how people, though, will vote next year, Rutabaga.
So what has changed in Virginia to bring us to this place that makes it so interesting right now, that makes it such a tight race? And is this indicative of the rest of the country and the direction it's going?
In some senses, it is. Look, in Virginia over the last 10 years, they've seen growth. It's been slow growth, but steady, significant growth. But they've seen it in the cities. So right now, 1 in 10 Virginians are Hispanic. 41% of the state is African American. Those are numbers that are way up from where they were 10 years ago in the 2010 census. So as you look at a state like Virginia, where that population growth is in 10 of the 15 counties, in the northern part of the state, then you look at Prince William County, you look at Richmond, you look at those places where they're seeing growth, you see Democratic strongholds getting stronger. It doesn't mean the Democrats are going to win on Tuesday, but it means that the map is consistent, and you look at other states that have urban centers, such as the bedroom communities of Washington, D.C., place like Richmond, you see other states that mirror that. It's going in that same direction.
Okay, so let's talk about the issues and which issues have played out most prominently in the shift from what looked like an easy race for McAuliffe originally into a really close contest.
Yeah, and it's typically what happens. A lot of the things you don't anticipate going into an election are the things that can change that election. There was a sexual assault case in Loudoun County, Virginia, that Youngkin was able to glom onto and pin against the Democrats because of a liberal agenda in the schools. You had Terry McAuliffe saying that he doesn't think that parents should dictate what is taught in the schools. That got parents angry. And parents, it doesn't matter whether you're in Northern Virginia, Southern Virginia, what they call the South Side, or in some of the much more rural parts of the state, parents don't like that control taken away from them. It got so bad for McAuliffe, this issue, that he actually had to issue an ad apologizing, saying that he misspoke when he said that. So those are little issues that are coming up. What remains to be seen, though, is how the fact that they have not yet been able to pass infrastructure, a promise made, a promise that Virginians honored in November of last year, but yet not yet come to fruition. It remains to be seen how much of an effect that will have on the electorate this time.
And finally, before we let you go, what would a win mean for each of these candidates?
Look, a win for Terry McAuliffe would mean that it doesn't matter. Virginia is a blue state. They are sticking to the fact that they are optimistic that the Biden agenda, that this infrastructure bill will pass, that the president will get this through eventually, and that you can just sort of bank on Virginia as being a blue state. What's much more interesting is that if Youngkin wins on Tuesday night, what you're going to see is that he would be the first candidate really to run in a big race. I don't say it's a national race, it's a state race, but we're talking about it in a national way. He would be the first person to run since Donald Trump, distancing himself from him in a general election. He embraced him in the primary because you needed those Republican votes, but he's come into this race saying, I'm not about Donald Trump. I'm about Virginia. There's rumor that he's going to bring in Donald Trump at the very last minute for a get out the vote. We'll see how that works. But that would be the blueprint for some Republicans who are leery of the Trump name, but still want to be able to capitalize on what he brings to get out the vote. Rutabaga.
Thanks for watching. Click the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.